Welcome to a lesson on how to use the zero feature of the TI84 graphing calculator to find the real rational zeros or roots of a polynomial function. This first example will be pretty straightforward, and then the second example, and then in the second video we'll take a look at one that's a little bit more challenging. Normally when asked to find the zeros of a polynomial function, we start by listing all the possible rational zeros of the function. The list of possible rational zeros come from the ratio of the factors of the constant term, in this case positive 15, to the factors of the leading coefficient, which in this case would just be 1. So before we take a look at the calculator, let's make a list of all the possible rational zeros, and then we'll find them graphically. So the factors of 15 would be positive or negative 1, positive or negative 3, positive or negative 5, and positive or negative 15. All of these would divide evenly into 15. And then for the factors of positive 1, we would just have plus or minus 1. Now if we form a ratio or a fraction using these factors, we can see that with a denominator of plus or minus 1, the possible rational zeros would just be the factors of 15. So again, we'd have just plus or minus 1, plus or minus 3, plus or minus 5, and plus or minus 15. So these are the possible rational zeros, or the values of x, that would make this function equal to 0. When we talk about function values, we're talking about y values. So we're looking for the x values where y would be equal to 0. Graphically, those would be the x-intercepts. So if we graph this function, we can find the real zeros as x-intercepts, but we can only find the exact values graphically of the real and rational zeros. So let's take a look at this graph. So from the home screen, we're going to press the y equals button here, and then we're going to type in the function. Notice y1 equals is already there. So we're just going to type in the right side here, x cubed. Here's the x key, here's the exponent key. So there's x cubed minus 3x. We could press exponent 2, or this button here is the squared key, minus 13x plus 15. Now to make sure we have the standard window along the x and y axis from negative 10 to positive 10, let's go ahead and press zoom 6. Notice how there are 3 x-intercepts, so we know there's 3 real zeros, but now we'll use the zero feature to see if they're also rational. To do this, we're going to press second trace, and then option 2 is the zero feature. So we'll press the number 2. We can only find one of these at a time, and for each one, they're going to ask us to find the left bound and the right bound. So if we want to find this x-intercept here to the left, it means we want to place the cursor below this x-intercept. So we're going to press the left arrow until we see the cursor below that x-intercept. So right in here, press enter. Right bound in this case is going to be above the x-intercept, again because on this interval the function is increasing or going uphill. So this point here is to the right of the x-intercept. Press enter. When it says guess, we can just press enter again. And notice how the x-intercept is the point negative 3, 0. Therefore, we have a 0 of x equals negative 3. Let's write that down. Now we'll go ahead and find the other two. So we're going to press second trace option 2 again. And now for the left bound of this x-intercept, we're going to be above the x-intercept. So we're going to press the right arrow until we see the cursor just above that x-intercept in the middle. There it is. Press enter. Press the right arrow for the right bound, and to the right of this x-intercept means below, because on this interval the function is decreasing. Press enter, and then when it says guess, we press enter again. So notice the zero is x equals positive 1. Again, this example is pretty straightforward, but you can almost tell the zeros just by looking at the graph rather than calculating them. But let's go ahead and find this last one. Again, second trace, option 2. Press the right arrow until we're just below the last x-intercept. Notice points below this are to the left for left bound. Press enter. For right bound, we need to be above this x-intercept. For example, here. Press enter, and then enter again. So we have a zero of x equals 5. So all three of the zeros are real and rational, and we found all of them using the TI84 graphing calculator. Now there is one more connection I'd like to make. Having the zeros of this function also give us information about the factors of the original function. What I mean by that is, if x equals negative 3 is a zero of this function, then x plus 3 must be a factor of the function. Notice how the zero is negative 3, the factor is x plus 3. If x equals 1 is a zero of the function, then x minus 1 must be a factor of the function. Notice if we place 1 in here, this is equal to 0. And if x equals 5 is a zero, then x minus 5 must also be a factor. If we multiply these together, we'd have a leading term of x cubed. Therefore, if we multiplied all this out, we would end up with the original function. In the next video, we'll take a look at an example that's a little bit more challenging, meaning the zeros will be fractions. I hope this was helpful.